They're shooting at you right now. Oh. Ah! Welcome back to Voyage Thru The Dreamscape. As soon as I hit the pause button to stop the recording, we started getting shot at immediately.
Because combat never ends.
Not this time. So since we're still in never-ending combat, where I left off last episode is some of my friends were in a pirate party that I was running for D&D. It was very, like, high fantasy, high seas, swashbuckling weirdness. And they were playing... I have this setting that I made called the Wild Sea. And the Wild Sea... things are weird. Like, that's the best way to put it. I mean... on the Wild Sea, there's a group of shamanistic orcs who are led by a Blackbeard equivalent who straight up often tries to get himself killed so that he can respawn. Whatever... It's faster than healing.
Boat back to town.
Right. He also is known for doing things such as killing his whole crew, bringing them back as zombies, because they're more convenient that way. In this same universe, I have a pirate captain who is a howler monkey man. His name's Captain Windsong. This is his inside voice!
Yeah, he's very...
I love him.
He's very quiet, that
one. He's one of my favorite things I've ever made as a world-building device.
This bridge is awfully convenient.
It looks like a cutscene bridge. See those scorch marks? Gunpowder. Watch your step. This bridge is so collapsing on us halfway through this.
Yep. Good thing you didn't let go of that camera.
Well, you know, we can't lose that. Give me your other hand! Can't hold it back anymore.
Point.
You know what? Because they don't show it get destroyed, it's clearly gonna be fine.
Oh yeah.
We have to go back for it.
Okay. Oh shit!
It's okay.
Look, it's calling out for me.
Oh no. It's okay, come on.
I don't get what the point of those, like, four guys that I killed was. It's like, it didn't lead to any more combat, which is what was expected.
That's weird.
It just turned into this bridge cutscene.
It was basically just to force you to climb that, rather than get any moment to pause. But anyway, this pirate party is really ridiculous. They were, like, a fish man.
Treasure.
A woman who'd been brought back from the dead by the Loas, with an unknown reason. Silver Spanish chalice. A rat man who hated the dead girl because she was unclean. He was a druid. And a voodoo priestess Dwergar, because that's how weird those islands were. Underground species were commonplace above ground and normal people, whereas some traditionally normal species of D&D races were not commonplace.
Yeah.
Like, the only known halflings in the Wild Sea are the Dread Midget Pirates of Willygoat, former research team driven mad by a unknown artifact.
Wait, that's not her. I thought that was her.
Nope.
You survived being shot in the spine without falling over. You are impressive.
Yeah, his backpack was really thick. But anyway. So this is this pirate party. I sent them through a whole bunch of weird scenarios, collecting these mysterious orbs. And because I know this game's never continuing, I can spoil what they were meant to be. But they were supposed to be spell jamming helms for alien spacecrafts.
I'm perfectly okay with them being MacGuffin crystals.
That's how weird that universe
was.
Speaking of MacGuffins, wow. Quadamundis! Quadamundis are fun animals. I think that's cool that we got a weird rainforest animal as an amulet. We haven't gotten much stuff that's like that.
NPC
please,
in my way.
Let us continue up the stairs.
Yes.
But amongst the weird things I've had them run into was I created a Temple of the Forbidden Eye-inspired dungeon. But the difference is this. I traded out Mara... in the traditional sense, as a faux Hindu-ish style deity for a Cthulhu-like entity.
I almost shot her because she ran away from me.
Eldritch sort of monster. And so, like, the biggest difference was, like, as you go walking through the temple at the beginning, you, like, when you see the three different hints and the oh, not the jet ski again.
Please tell me you have a grenade launcher.
On the three, rewards.
No, it's pistol, right.
Riches, knowledge, or youth. The riches and youth ones look just like they do on the Indiana Jones ride at Disneyland. So you see an old man climbing into a well and he comes back young and strong. And you see someone else walking through a chamber and becoming fabulously wealthy. But the last one, which this is my favorite, is if you get knowledge of the future, the knowledge of the future images that they could find if they were actually looking at the hieroglyphs on the wall show a man on his knees screaming towards the heavens. Ooh, as a mysterious tentacle-faced figure, Mind Flayer, stood behind him. And in that universe, they didn't know what Mind Flayers were, so that was really fun. But anyway, they go through the chamber, they go working their way through solving past the traps. They get past the traps that were in the ride queue, which, yes, I actually lay out the dungeon with, like, my dungeon tiles to exactly match the ride queue at the ride.
Sorry, I'm just
rock surfing? Okay, this looks really tedious.
You have to fight the current.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. You are clearly slowly fighting the current, and, ugh. I mean, that jet ski's already really unwieldy. This looks no fun, Chris. I am sorry. Come on.
Take it. Eat it, Poseidon.
But anyway, so we got through that part, and they go into the Hall of Promise, and I actually played the ride audio from the ride.
You got it.
And you hear them walking through the gates of, "You choose glittering gold. It is yours." And as they go walking through there, their captain, being a smart guy, starts handing out bags of holding to everybody.
That's the thing you
and
do.
Just, like, stuffing treasure into bags. And, suddenly, they hear, "Foolish infidels, you've looked into my eyes. Now you face the gates of doom." And,
Heroclip.
They then meet Chris's character.
Yeah, Captain Steve.
Captain Steve. Captain is his first name, not his title. Yes.
No, his title is Captain.
Yeah, so he's Captain Steve. And,
putting barrels into the frickin' water.
Long and short, Captain Steve is a space pirate from, like, literal space. Like, he's an alien. And he is standing in front of this temple, this statue, mooing,
yep,
while waddling fake tentacles on his chin using his hand,
yep,
at the evil statue that is screaming at the minds of everybody else.
That's what you gotta do.
That he is going to send them past the gates of doom.
Captain Steve knows what's up.
And that was when I sucker punched my players, and they suddenly realized their universe wasn't a fantasy universe, it was a sci-fi one. And that was really fun,
yeah,
because they were just like, "Wait, what?" And I go, "And it gets better. You're dealing with some Eldritch Horror nonsense." And they're just like, "Why? Why would you do this to us?" And I go, "Because I can." But then from there, they still had to navigate the room full of zombies, cross the bridge that was on that's getting shot at by laser beams, fight the giant cobra.
Yeah,
it was really fun.
It was good.
And it was in general just a fun time. I look forward to running that map again as a beginner's map, because I've got some kids, and weirdly enough, in my high school class that really want to play D&D. So I'm probably going to run a beginner's game for the improv club that I am the club advisor for. I've already played a game of Dread with them. They had a lot of fun doing that. Dread's a survival horror RPG.
Anyone survive?
Never played is, like, the best thing ever. Yes, two characters survived. The quiet, bookish girl who didn't want to be there, and the stoner characters.
Okay.
And because of it, it fit the narrative. So, like, we're the two characters who least, like, should have survived in the narrative wound up being our survivors.
Of course.
It worked out really well. But Dread's a really fun game, too. So I'm probably going to play the Indiana Jones game again.
Yeah.
Eventually, we might have to make a show about this.
Yeah?
Yeah. like where we do more stuff with counter monkeying.
This doesn't feel like I'm driving on water right now.
No, it looks like you're driving on carpet.
Yeah.
The water effects in this game either go from really beautiful to really weird.
Okay, I drove that hellscape. That wet hellscape.
And it was a good way to get us
the Lord unlocked.
Ooh, we got a secret in the bonus menu. Is it that you never have to ride a jet ski again?
God, I hope so. Or maybe that the jet ski rides itself.
That would be awesome. It's like you get on it and then you just get off at the next spot.
You get on it and, you know, you maybe have to, like, shoot something once every couple of minutes and then
you're
there.
That'd be a nice cheat.
It is really dark in here.
Yeah, it is. Should I turn the lights off?
Yeah, maybe.
We might have to. All right. Ugh. But yeah.
I don't suggest ever playing through that segment of the level. It's
just, it doesn't look fun.
It was annoying.
Oh yeah, that helps.
Yeah. I can see.
Real talk. We're playing using a projector.
Always.
Which is always how I seem to be playing for my show.
That's not fair.
Neither is that.
Oh wait.
Ugh.
Yeah, you're...
But yeah, so that's the time I made an Indiana Jones temple.
It was good.
It was a fun... It's probably one of more fun dungeons I got to build. It's a shame that
run it a bit short, and so we kind of glossed over some of the stuff.
And we just kind of roleplayed it later, like, just roleplay only with the members of the party that still lived in Southern California, because half the group moved, and, they might be watching this show, at least one of them, but still, I'm legitimately disappointed that we just kind of had to end it because they didn't ever come back.
Yeah.
But at the same time, that seems to be a recurring theme for me with D&D games. If I run a long-going campaign and make a really cool dungeon, the party stops existing afterwards.
Yeah, that happens.
Because that happened to our Dark Sun campaign, too, when I,
Oh, my God!
Oh, my God. Haven't we seen this already?
So what?
Yeah, I actually watched one of these in action do this to a guy in front of me.
This wasn't made by the Spanish. I don't
need a camera.
Take a closer look at the spikes.
It wasn't made by the Spanish. Take a closer look at the spikes.
You've got to be kidding me.
This is from our plane.
Wait,
it's
that
from
doesn't
their
make
plane.
Any sense, though. Why would someone set traps like this when their own men are crawling
all over the
island?
Why would someone drag pieces of the plane all the way over here?
Yeah,
to
well,
make traps like this.
Something's been here since.
This kind of looks like we could be
something or someone
back where in the jungle area from where we crashed the plane.
I don't know, man.
Hear what?
Do you hear that?
Nothing.
No.
Absolutely nothing. We're being watched.
And that's when you pull out your gun.
They're being watched. Yeah, by us.
You know what? It's probably
yeah,
nothing.
Player.
And
it's
by the audience.
Get out of here before we run into whatever's been chewing on this guy.
Nolan North, you're not playing Deadpool right now.
Right now.
You don't have to get meta. That's another one of those times where it sat a little too long on the dead guy, and I kind of almost want a zombie jump scare.
They said, like, chewed on, but this guy doesn't look like he's been chewed on.
He honestly doesn't look that different from the guys you were just shooting at earlier.
I mean, he's probably one of them.
But you know what I mean? Like, he's supposed to be
wasn't
a mangled...
responsible for...
he's supposed
and
to be
there's
a...
just regular shooting guys. Yeah, thanks for the...
Roll to evade laser targeting? Why would you bother laser targeting that close? That was really dumb. You're like 3 feet away from the guy, and he's like going, let me get the laser sight on you.
That was an equally dumb segment of combat.
There's been quite a few of those in this session. Yeah, that laser sight seems really stupid.
What the heck? He's not dead.
He is dressed super tactical. That was... Huh. I'm so glad that I'm not doing this, because I suck at this kind of stuff, but jeez.
Put a whole clip into him, he's still kicking.
Thank he's you. Running away. There you go.
I gotta deal with Mr. Laser Sight over here. Just gonna put like a whole clip into him.
I was gonna say, just drop a grenade on him.
Solve that problem.
That'll work. Got one of them that way. There's two more. Oh, they're throwing grenades back.
Seem like they're potentially a different faction.
These guys do seem to be in more like militaristic gear. Like they're less guerrilla and more like kitted out. Right, these guys kind of have that,
They go down pretty easily to it. Yeah, now the MP4s and, like, Desert Eagles.
Yeah, they're very much that, like, Army for Hire kind of vibe.
Yeah, maybe.
The private they're paramilitary, that's what it is.
Paramilitary.
Versus, what, the other guys, which kind of felt like guerrilla mercenary kind of dudes.
Roman and Navarro can't be far off if they've left their attack.
This is 92. Oh, Beretta.
Ooh.
I know my handguns.
Oh, it's got a higher capacity, too.
Yeah, Berettas have the ability to have fully automatic capabilities.
Oh, nice.
Whether or not this one does, I will find out, I'm sure.
That was a very, like, Dagobah cave-looking frog there.
All right, where's Yoda? He's got to teach me how to float rocks.
Yeah, and we need to face Darth Vader and discover that it's us underneath his mask. What?
Yep.
Okay, that's a scene I would pay to see in an Uncharted game.
I want the library secure. Don't let them get to
sunlight. No, like...
Nathan Drake goes walking into a foggy swamp, meets Yoda.
I think instead of it being Nathan Drake's face, it would just be, like, Mark Hamill's current face.
That would be sufficiently scary.
Yeah, it's a burst rifle, or a burst pistol. It feels like... No, it's just doing single fire.
It just shoots with some more recoil, and it hits a little harder because it knocks them back.
Yeah. Over
there. Okay. God, the laser targeting is so goofy.
Oh, boy.
Because you could practically just run up and punch these guys.
Yeah, what's the point?
With their stupid laser targeting.
They're not even shooting at me with their laser targeting. They're just, like, swinging it at me.
Well, it's because they're trying to get
a beat
on you.
It's not a lightsaber, sir.
I'm trying to blind him with my laser. Shouldn't we just shoot him? Nah, that wouldn't work.
I like how they essentially like brought the fog in, so there's a reason why you're able to see the whole laser.
Yeah.
Because they wanted these laser enemies.
Nate, I've got a bad feeling about this.
It's pretty silly. Got a bad feeling.
Let's just find someone.
Got a bad
get
feeling that you know Nate's never going to be able to hold this controller again.
I'm starting to accept that.
I don't want that.
There's going to be some sort of like survival chase thing again, like a dramatic moment.
Yeah.
Where if nothing else, like we have to run away from something
triple
that's falling
dynamite.
Apart. That is a great trophy.
You have a shotgun.
Are you gonna go take it? Well, there's a guy up there too. Jeez. Just a cavalcade of dudes.
And I have come to take him. Oh yes.
Ooh,
Fast 12.
Nice.
That's what it actually is supposed to be, but obviously there's some gun licensing.
Yeah.
Which is why this is not a Beretta 93R.
Right. But it's
and why it's a Desert 5 instead of a Desert Eagle.
Yeah.
I don't know who's friendly and who's not. She's friendly. He's not.
Oh, there's a guy with a laser.
Yeah. He has looks to be an M16.
Wow, that was a nice headshot. Yeah.
They flip out weird.
They do.
Can I? Can be close. You're welcome.
He ran away from it.
I don't think he got hit. I think he was sliding into cover.
Yeah, that or what's her name tagged him.
I don't think so.
Oh, yep, just sliding into cover. Oh yeah, their shotguns are noticeably better than the last one. That put you to, like, instant gray.
The other one was like a Remington, essentially. Nope. No kick option.
Was there, Oh, it's because there's more guys to fight.
Get out.
He just did like a triple axel.
He was in his in another life. He was clearly a ballerina.
Yeah, that was a that was quite a graceful.
I almost feel bad about that one.
Take down. A hint. Platforming.
Here, do it.
Okay,
do it
I will do that next time on Voyage Thru The Dreamscape.